Hello student, Hemant sir is here. So in previous video, we have understood all about the asexual reproduction. And according to the asexual reproduction with their types, we have understood the concept map on that also. Okay. So today we are going to start the sexual reproduction, which is the part of your science class 10, life process in living organism, which is your one of the chapter. Okay, so let's start. What is sexual reproduction? Okay, so what is sexual reproduction basically? Asexual reproduction में हमने देखा था, for the reproduction only one parent is required. But in sexual reproduction, there are two parents required. One is male and another one is female. Okay, so let's understand what is sexual reproduction. So the reproduction in which the reproduction in which two gametes, one is male gamete and female gamete, or combine to form the reproduction in which two gametes combine to form a diploid zygote which develops into new organism is called as sexual reproduction. So the important thing is here two gametes, that is one is male gamete and another is female gamete, they fuses to form diploid zygote, and then diploid zygote turns into the blastocyst, and when it implant in uterus, then there is a embryonic development stages takes place to form a new organism. Okay, so this is nothing but the sexual reproduction. What is sexual reproduction? The reproduction in which two gametes, one is male gamete and another is female gamete, they combine to form a single diploid zygote, which develops into the new organism. This type of reproduction is called as sexual reproduction. Okay, so let's understand the process. So in sexual reproduction, the process of sexual reproduction completes in two steps. Number one is gamete formation or formation of gametes, and number two is fertilization. So what is the formation of gametes? Okay, so in the formation of gamete, in the formation of gametes, male and female, male and female germ cells divides by meiosis Meiosis is the type of cell division that we have understood in previous chapter, okay, which is in life process in living organism part 1, and this is the part 2. This is part 2, okay. So in life process in living organism part 1, we have understood about the gamete formation, okay, and where we have understood the meiosis process in detail. अगर आपको मियोसिस प्रोसेस को समझना है सो जस्ट गो थ्रू योर प्रीवियस चैप्टर्स वीडियो ओके सो यू विल गेट डिटेल अबाउट द मियोसिस टाइप ऑफ सेल डिवीजन ओके सो इन गैमेट फॉर्मेशन इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट और वी कैन से द हैप्लॉइड गैमेट मेल एंड फीमेल जर्म सेल डिवाइड्स बाय मियोसिस सेल डिवीजन टू फॉर्म haploid gametes. So what is meaning of haploid? What is the meaning of haploid? So haploid means the cell which contain half the number of chromosome as parent cell that is N. Okay, the cell which contain half the number of chromosome as parent cell, then it is called as haploid cell or haploid gamete. Okay. एप्लॉइड का मतलब भी होता है जब भी मियोटिकली सेल का डिवीजन होगा तो क्रोमोसोम का नंबर जो पेरेंट सेल में रहेगा उसके मियोसिस वाली जो सेल में फॉर्म होगी हम उसको बोलते हैं जर्म सेल वहां पर क्रोमोसोम का नंबर हाफ हो जाता है दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज हैप्लॉइड गैमेट और हैप्लॉइड सेल और यहां पर जो डिप्लॉइड वर्ड यूज हुआ है दैट मीन्स ये हो गया एप्लॉइड और ये हो गया डिप्लॉइड सो डिप्लॉइड का मीनिंग होता है द सेल कंटेन टू एन नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम ओके 2n का मतलब भी होता है देखो यहां पर n है तो ये पेरेंट सेल है यहां पर 2n होगा ओके देन ये मेल और फीमेल गैमेट जब फ्यूज होंगे देन दे फॉर्म डिप्लॉइड जायगोट दैट मींस अब उनका जो क्रोमोसोम का नंबर डबल हो जाएगा देन दिस जायगोट विल डेवलप इनटू द न्यू इंडिविजुअल ओके नाउ सो व्हाट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट इज नथिंग बट इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेल डिवीजन वेयर जर्म सेल डिवाइड मियोटिकली टू फॉर्म द हैप्लॉइड गैमेट्स ओके अब हैप्लॉइड गैमेट एक होगा मेल के लिए और दूसरा होगा फीमेल के लिए ओके सो व्हेन टू हैप्लॉइड गैमेट दैट इज वन इज फ्रॉम द फीमेल एंड अनदर इज फ्रॉम द मेल व्हेन दे कंबाइन टू फॉर्म अ डिप्लॉइड जायगोट दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज फर्टिलाइजेशन सो लेट अंडरस्टैंड फर्टिलाइजेशन तो फर्टिलाइजेशन इज द प्रोसेस इन विच हैप्लॉइड मेल गैमेट एंड फीमेल गैमेट यूनाइट का मतलब होता है टू कंबाइन ओके यूनाइट टू फॉर्म डिप्लॉइड जायगोट दे फॉर्म डिप्लॉइड जायगोट अगेन डिप्लॉइड इज द सेल कंटेन टू एन नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम सी वन एन इज फ्रॉम मेल एंड अनदर वन एन इज फ्रॉम फीमेल व्हेन दे कंबाइन सो दे विल फॉर्म द टू एन नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम इन देयर सेल दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज डिप्लॉइड जायगोट ओके सो देन डिप्लॉइड जायगोट विल डेवलप इन टू द न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड डिप्लॉइड जायगोट develops into new organism or new individual. This process is called as fertilization. Okay, so the sexual reproduction completes in two basic steps. One is formation of gamete and another one is fertilization. Okay, so student, this is a very important part that you have to write on your notebook. So you can, if you want to write, you can write or take a screenshot also. Okay, so write down now. So let understand this process with the help of diagrammatic representation. Okay, so suppose this is the male gamete. This is the not male gamete, it is a male germ cell which contain 2n number of chromosomes. Then we have female germ cell which also contain 2n number of chromosomes. So they are parent. So we can write here P1 generation. What is P1 generation? It is first parental generation. Okay. So they contain 2n number of chromosomes. That means they contain diploid cell. Okay, because they contain 2n number of chromosomes. 2n is nothing but the 2n set of chromosomes. So this symbol represents the male and this symbol represents for the female. Okay, so this is a parent generation. Okay, they are nothing but the germ cells. So here we have to write more information. They are male and female germ cell. Okay, they are male germ cell and female germ cell. Okay, so male and female germ cells, they are nothing but the diploid cell. They are the parent generation. Now, then this cell divides to form. See, the process of cell division is meiosis. Meiosis type of cell division takes place. So they form four haploid cells. Okay, see, so the chromosome number is reduced to n. अब देख, उनके पास n है, that means अब ये हो गए, क्या हो गए, एक्चुअल में ये हो गए haploid cell हो गए. Okay, so this is for the male and this is for the female. They also contain n number of chromosomes and this process is again called as meiosis type of cell division. Okay, see, here the number of chromosomes is reduced to half, that means diploid cell convert into haploid cell. So they are gametes of P1 generation. They are haploid cell. What is haploid cell? They contain n number of chromosomes. Okay, that's why they are called as haploid cell. Now, These are the male germ cell and the male gametes, and these are the female gametes. So these are male gametes and these are female gametes. Okay. Now, this male gamete and female gamete going to fuse to form diploid zygote. Let this cell is going to combine with this cell. Okay. So, they will form this M plus this M equals to 2M. Okay, so here, see 2N number of chromosomes present in zygote, that's why it is called as diploid zygote. Okay, so in all the cases, diploid cell is formed. Okay, so this is nothing but the diploid cell. So here we have to write, this is the male gamete and it is zygote. That is zygote, which is diploid in nature. Diploid zygote. Okay, that means they contain 2N number of chromosomes. Okay, so here we can see that one chromosome is from the male and one chromosome is from the female. That means we can say this zygote, or when individual is formed, will contain half character from the male and half character from female. Okay, so this is nothing but the hybrid new individual, या हम लिखेंगे hybrid individual, which contain so why this is hybrid individual, because they contain zygote contain 50% character from male parent and 50% character from female parent. That's why the new individuals are hybrid in nature. Okay, and this hybrid nature is going to create the variation in new individual, which creates variation in organism. This variation helps new individual to adapt in changing environment. Okay. And they maintain their existence. And they maintain their existence. Means they protect themselves from being extinct. So from here, I am writing over here, okay? So this helps organism to protect from being extinct. Okay, so ये उनको लुप्त होने के कगार से बचाता है. That is nothing but the meaning of this health organism to protect from being extinct. Okay, so these are the benefit of sexual reproduction and this is the process how the new individuals are formed from their parents. Okay, so students, this is the very important part that you have to write, and for better understanding just keep repeat this video once. Okay, so students, आज के लिए इतना ही. मिलते हैं next video में. In next video lecture we will continue about the sexual type of reproduction in plants. Okay, so students, write down or you can take a screenshot also.